Exodus chapter 1. Now in context here we have the king over Egypt who would like to suppress a people. He wants to suppress the Israelites because they're increasing in number, and he fears that they may overtake him and his rule. So in his judgment, he decides to instruct the midwives to kill the boys that are born to the Hebrew women so that he might stop the numbers from increasing. And that is similar to what is going on here in our selfishness and in our lack of fear of God. We pursue the death of innocent children. And we need to stop this. We need to not make the same heinous and grievous decision that the king of Egypt made to put to death innocent children. But as this story continues, the midwives, that they fear God more than they fear men. This is what we need to do. We need to fear God over fear. We need to put a stop. We need to put a stop to this atrocity, this murdering of innocent children.
Good morning.
We need to recognize the sanctity of this life. In Genesis chapter 1, we read in the very beginning that God created the heavens and the earth. We continue to read through that passage of scripture. We come to a verse that says God created man in his own image. He created male and female. So we as human beings are unique and distinct from all of creation. We've been created in the very image and likeness of God. And the purpose of which what it is that we are doing in this place here. We need to put a stop to this murdering of children. Not just for the simple sake of the children, although that would be enough, but for the sake of God and the fact that He has commanded us not to do this. We have no fear of God. Like this, murdering children, sinning against
there is reconciliation. There is hope. And that hope is in Jesus' blood. We can repent of our sins, trust in Jesus Christ to be our Lord, and be forgiven of our sins. We'll be granted eternal life. God will cause us to be born again. He'll open up our eyes, our hearts, and our minds, so that we would understand God's will, so that we would see the truth of this life, and that we repent of our sin. What is happening here in this establishment is sin. It is against God. And I know that you do not understand that. Scripture speaks to that. Darkness in your mind. But I preach to you this gospel of life, so that through the power of the Holy Spirit, you might open your minds and your hearts to understand this truth, to turn from this sin, to trust in Jesus Christ, and to do His will, to love, to obey, and to follow Him. You're not guaranteed another day in this life. This point of man wants to die and then to judgment. If you were to stand before God in judgment, right here and now, if you go to heaven or hell, if you have not repented of your sin and trusted in Jesus Christ, you will go to hell for all of eternity. And God has made a way for us to be made right. He has given us grace and mercy through His Son, Jesus Christ, that we need not be foolish and disregard that as something that is for the grace is through. Grace and mercy that God has demonstrated through His Son. Repent of our sins. Trust in Jesus Christ and Him alone. We're not here to condemn you. We're not here to be jerks. We're here to talk to you about truth and life. We're here out of grace and mercy, that you would see your sin and turn from it and come to Jesus Christ. We plead with you, good folks, to consider these things.
Good, how are you?
I just wanted to come out and talk to you for a second.
Sure.
So folks, recognize this. Come to terms with this. You are alive. You are alive. You are something. You are a thief. If you have looked, if you've looked at a person to lust after them, you've committed adultery with them. Strong and feed in the judgment. Folks, in the Lord, Jesus Christ, gets that forgave to die on the cross to take the punishment for our sin upon himself. He calls us to repent, to turn from our sins, to have faith and trust in Jesus Christ, the finished work that he performed. And then as seeking and calling us to himself, he petitions us to respond, to come to him as a good shepherd, going into the darkness and finding his sheep, beckoning them to come to him. So please, hear the call of the good shepherd today. Respond. Come to him in faith. Turn from your sin. Turn from your wicked ways. Or else there is nothing but judgment for those who would deny God, who would deny the Christ, the Messiah, Jesus Christ, who came to seek and save that which is lost. Do not be a fool, but repent and turn from your sins and trust in Jesus Christ today.